Oh, no, that's fine, yeah.
Okay, so is there any good evidence for God? I would say no, and that's why I left. I left primarily for two scientific reasons, and that is evolution and neurology and the consequences of what those bring out. So the first one with evolution, because of biological evolution, I think a consequence of that is that there was no Adam and Eve. And that means there was no fall from paradise. There's really no basic for the gospel, because the gospel, when it's preached, usually says that we were in some kind of perfect ideal state and man sinned, and that's why we have this curse now, and Jesus came to reverse all of that. So when somebody believes in evolution, they no longer believe in Adam and Eve. Just to stress that point, there's a movement in evangelical Christianity called evolutionary creationism, and I was part of that before I left finally, but like here's a book written by Dennis Lamoureux. He's a professor with three PhDs, two in science, one in theology, and that's one of the things he tries to tell his fellow evangelicals is there's no such thing as Adam and Eve. It's ancient cosmology, Hebrew cosmology, just like they believed in a firmament, but there is no such thing as a firmament. So the first one is evolution. The second one is neurology. And I think given with neurology, we can say for sure there's no soul. And if there's no soul, that means no supernatural soul. There's no resurrection. And if there's no resurrection, that means there's no resurrection of Jesus either. So we might talk more about that, about the mind and evidence for any kind of supernatural things there. Now, when I was a Christian, I believed in evolution. I accepted evolution. And I thought, well, you know, should I leave Christianity? I thought, well, maybe there's still something there. Maybe there's still this idea of an afterlife. Maybe I could just say, forget about dogma. And some of these people I know, they're really kind of mysticists. They kind of go into this mysticism where they had this love and devotion to Jesus. And you read the Bible just to see what positive things are out of it, but you don't read it with a critical eye. And it's really all about Jesus and this hope in eternal life that Jesus rose from the grave, and we can have that. So then I thought, well, is there any way to disprove the idea that there's a resurrection or that Jesus didn't rise from the grave? And my first answer to that was, of course not. You know, there's no way to disprove that. But as I thought about it and went to some conferences and things, it came to me that there are some, I think, hints that make it likely Jesus did not rise from the dead. And what that is that I think there's problems in the Bible enough to show that the stories are made up. One of them is in Acts. It says Jesus ascended into heaven. They all saw Jesus go rise up to heaven, and you know he went past the clouds, and that's the way the story is. Well, in their cosmology, their idea of the cosmos, heaven was physically located up there. So if you're going to make up a story about Jesus or somebody ascending in the heaven, they're going to literally ascend in the heaven. But if you're going to write that story today, we know heaven is not up there because we have spaceships and space probes. Our whole idea of what heaven is a different idea now. Nowadays, people say, well, it's a different dimension. It's not literally up in the sky. So because they believed it was literally up in the sky, they got caught holding a fib. Now, if heaven is not in the sky, and Jesus knew that, why would Jesus make this kind of a ascension into heaven? I mean, it's like theatrics, you know? Is it trying to put on a good show? It doesn't really make sense, you know? So it would make sense according to them in their day if it was a made-up story, but with today's knowledge, it doesn't make sense. The other one is there's these things in the gospel that show the gospels have a bunch of myth in there. Like one is it says when Jesus died on the cross, the graves opened and these dead people walked around. Well, most Christians think that was added. That wasn't really part of the original, even though it's in the oldest manuscripts. Another passage, that was Mark 27. In Mark 18, it says that Christians will dance with snakes and poison won't kill them if they drink it. So that's another example of obvious myth. I have a bunch of other things, but basically, since I'm out of time, I'm going to go to the very last thing. A lot of evidence, and I think when you hear what evidence Neil has, it's probably going to boil down to God of the gaps, which is bad theology even. Basically, it's like we don't know the answer to some things, like how did the Big Bang start? Therefore, that's evidence for God. No, it's not evidence for God. It's evidence for ignorance. It doesn't prove your case. And a lot of the evidence for God, I think, turns out to be God of the gaps kind of arguments. So, Neil, is that about 5 minutes to you?
Sounds good.
Okay.